G'day, here's a great way to identify new customers for your business. Greetings from Bali once again. Apologies for the nasally voice because I've got a bit of a flu bug at the moment. Can't seem to shake it, but we'll power through it as best we can. Now, The Blue Ocean Strategy is a book that I've spoken about a few times on the show before, and I would highly recommend you get your hands on it and read it. And don't just assume that you know what it's all about, frankly, which is what I did for a very long time. But once I read it, I found some really interesting bits. And one of the interesting bits I really like is this idea of non-customers and the commonalities of non-customers. And what they do is they identify three tiers of non-customers. You've got the soon-to-be non-customers, the ones that are actually, they used to be your customers before. They're probably dormant customers now. They haven't been for a while. For whatever reason, they've decided they don't really want to participate in your business, your service, your product anymore. So that's the soon-to-be non-customers. Then you've got the refusing non-customers who are a little further out from your current market. And they're the people that know all about your business. They know exactly what you've got to offer, but they just don't want it for whatever reason. And maybe it's because of the price. Maybe it's because of the location. Maybe it's because they just don't like the services you're offering. Could be a myriad of reasons. Bottom line is they've made a conscious decision that they are not your customers. And then further out are what we call the unexplored non-customers. And the unexplored non-customers are those people that don't even know that you exist. They've got no idea what products and services you sell. They've got no idea where you're located. And then what you do is you have a look at the characteristics or traits of these three tiers, these three groups of non-customers, the soon-to-be, the refusing, and the unexplored, and identify common traits amongst them. And within that, you have the potential of market demand. Well, it's actually real market demand. You have the potential of a new market that you can explore. So as an example, let's say that your soon-to-be non-customers have decided one of the traits of those soon-to-be non-customers is that the price has just gotten too much for them. They refuse to go based on the price now. And then your refusing customers, same thing. They've decided they'd love to go, but the price is an issue. And so now you've got two traits that are common between those two tiers, those two groups of non-customers. And so one of the things that you could do is look at adjusting a price, having a cheaper treatment, having a cheaper product or service. Whether that means you change your whole business model or whether it just means offering a different service or a non-peak service, that sort of depends on how big that potential unexplored market is. So identify your non-customers, those three tiers of non-customers. Identify the common traits or characteristics between them, and within that, you basically have market demand. It's unmet market demand that's right there. You then need to decide whether it's worth your while to chase it or not, but effectively what you've now done is identify a blue ocean. So check it out, Blue Ocean Strategy, highly, highly recommended. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you've got any comments on this whole idea of non-customers. And yeah, look, we always talk about, you know, it's easier to maintain a current customer than to get a new customer. That's great, but at some point you're probably going to need to chase new customers. Identifying the commonalities of non-customers is a potential really good way to start. Do let me know in the comments below. I thank you for your time, and I will be back again tomorrow. See ya.